Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker. I have two motions to move. One is to approve option A and confirm the agreement that we made with Metrolinx to support the ORT plan. And option and number two is really what I believe is responsible for all of us to do, that whether you are going to be supporting A or B from the city manager's recommendations, at the very least, if somehow this subway scheme doesn't come through to fruition, if the provincial and federal governments don't work together as cooperatively as you hope they do with the city to fully fund it, that at least we confirm by the date that was set out by Metrolinx to move forward with the original Metrolinx agreement. Now, today we're faced with an incredibly important decision. We're either going to reaffirm to Metrolinx what we already agreed to as a council, or we're going to be spending over an additional $1 billion or more to replace a fully funded, and think about how rare it is that a high level of government is fully funding, not a partnership funding model, but a fully funded plan with seven stops that serves thousands of more Scarborough residents, and replace it with a three-stop subway extension. Now, if we just step away from, and I know there's a lot of politics on this, but if we just look at some basic facts. First of all, this is what we're talking about. We're talking about a completely grade-separated line. There are no cross signals. There are no cross streets or traffic signals, rather. There are no car lanes being ripped off. This is not analogous to St. Clair or any other debates that have been had in the past. This is a completely grade-separated line that, if just as was said before by staff, the maximum speeds of both the LRT and the subway are both 80 kilometers an hour. And far from being a streetcar, the Bombardier train, it's not a streetcar. That's the truth, by the way. It's actually not. It's called an LRT. And it averages 36 kilometers an hour. So that's faster than the current Yonge and Bloor Danforth lines, which average 32 kilometers an hour. It's faster than the existing subway we have now. The existing, the RT's alignment places it within walking distance of 20,000 more people than the three-stop subway extension could. It has the capacity to carry 16,000 passengers per hour, and it's anticipated that it will carry 8,000 passengers per hour by 2031, which means that it leaves plenty of opportunity for decades to come. This is clearly, the LRT in this specific route is clearly the fiscally responsible, most efficient, and best proposal for Scarborough. Now, some people say that the transfer at Kennedy Station is too onerous for some people. If you ask the chief planner, if you ask our experts, that does not impact people's interest in using rapid transit. In fact, you know, people use the Bloor transfer, St. George transfer every day, where you have to go up and down the stairs. This actually eliminates the current SRT three-story trek, and it actually is simply just a few meters across a platform where they will have a waiting train. And what they're looking for is to make sure that there's actually a high frequency of trains actually stopping at the station. Now, there's plenty more that we need to consider. $85 million in sunk engineering and design work. Think about that. We debate every budget time, you know, $1 million here, $2 million there. By going with the subway plan where it's not necessary, and by the way, there are places that are necessary to have subways. I believe that we need a subway on Pape. I think that we need one east-west corridor downtown as part of the downtown relief line, which has been already supported as the number one transit expansion priority by both Mr. Byford from the TTC and Ms. Kiesmatt, who's our chief planner and our city manager, and Metrolinx, and anyone else who actually looks at evidence. But to actually knowingly walk into a situation where we're just going to dump $85 million of tax dollars down the drain is just irresponsible. That's not left, that's not right, that's just wrong. And in the recent storm and the TTC delays due to our archaic signal system, which now will be repaired, we recognize that, and I know this isn't sort of sexy seconds. Or interesting, but state of good repair needs to be a priority for us too. Bottom line is, it's not a debate between LRTs and subways. We need subways where they make sense, where we have high density and projections. LRTs elsewhere, like this specific grade separate route. And finally, what residents are telling us from Scarborough to Etobicoke is this: stop reopening, stop debating, just get the friggin' plan done. Thank you.